Hi, I'm Matt MacPherson. I was president of the Royal Canadian Legion, Branch 60. I joined the Legion in around 1967. I was in for fish and chips one night, and they passed around a paper requesting volunteers. And one of the positions on the volunteer list was the financial committee. I thought, well, I could maybe help them in that. I was the financial chair at the Lowville United Church for 5 years or so. And through my work as a police officer, 35 and a half years, as district commander, I was responsible for my own budget. So I was familiar with a budget and a financial background. In 2007, I filled out this questionnaire as to what I'd be interested in volunteering, and I volunteered for the financial committee. I got a call a week or two later from the president, who at that time was John Grosiak, and he asked if I would be interested in being the treasurer. Well, I said, I'll do that. So I became treasurer in January 2007, was treasurer until June 1st, 2008, when I was elected to be president. At that time, the Legion was, we owed $38,000. We were facing a $58,000 lawsuit. Our mortgage was nearing the $400,000. So we owed a lot of money. And I reviewed all the contracts we had. We had contracts for fire extinguishers with one company, fire alarms with another company, fire grills over the kitchen fryers with another company. So, and each time the company came, there was a $50 service charge, I guess they called it. So we whittled it down, and within about 3 or 4 years, we had $50,000 in the bank. We were doing pretty good. And then our plumbing fell apart. Our plumbing fell apart to the tune of about $20,000. And the fire department came in and said, we have to change our smoke detectors to our fire detectors to smoke detectors. And we had to put smoke detectors in our beer freezer, or our beer coolers in our freezers. So that was another, I think, $15,000. So our money disappeared in a hurry, and we're back at square one again almost. But since then, we've done pretty good. Our mortgage at this point is $73,000. So in those 7 years, we reduced it by $300,000, which is remarkable. But that was due to the membership. When our mortgage came due, we asked them for donations, and they came through for us, and we took a big chunk off the principal twice in those years, which enabled us now to have $73,000 mortgage. I didn't expect to be here 13 years as president, but once I got going, my first year I was elected president, I believe it was three people stood for the executive, where we usually have six executives, three vice presidents, and a president. Anyway, I had three, so when I realized that I was president, I had to have committee chairs for various things like entertainment, fish and chips, everything, every function we have in here, Poppy, we had to have a chairman. So I didn't have enough bodies. So I went around, I asked people if they would serve as veteran service officer and entertainment chair and all those committees. And I was able to fill them. And the next year, I had 10 people stand for the executive. So I thought, with that kind of backing, I can stay. It's been quite a 13 years, had wonderful volunteers. We got about 50 volunteers come in here, three shifts each a month. four shifts a month doing fish and chips. Fish and chips has been our mainstay for the last 13 years, I guess. Outside of the fish, outside of special events and dances and our bar totals. Our ladies' auxiliary is another reason. I had the same ladies run the auxiliary, and they have been wonderful. 100% cooperation from everybody. In 2007, we hired Moira Edgerton as our associate administrator. And Moira is a wonderful person. She's smart and intelligent, and she controls our finances pretty good, as you can tell. My wife has been very active since I became president. She's chairman of the decorating committee. She's a member of the membership committee. She ran St. Patrick's Day for about 5-6 years. She works on fish and chips. She helps Moira, our treasurer, each Monday with the weekend monies. Anything that came up, she's there ready to do, ready to help. She's been very good. Even my daughters get involved. They come down for family day or holidays when Marguerite does the meals on most holidays, or did do the meals. She also ran Breakfast with Santa, which was a big thing, a lot of work. My daughters come down and they help serve on those days. My one daughter and my granddaughter-in-law, they were elves at the Breakfast with Santa. So my family has been fully involved also. Yes, we have dart teams and we have pool teams, eight ball and snooker teams. And we have card teams that go around. They go around to different regions and compete. All this is under the control now of Pam Regan, who's one of our bartenders, who volunteered to be our sports officer. And since Pam has taken over, we've won many trophies on the pool side and many more on the dart side. And when you win a tournament, you host the tournament the next year. So by hosting tournaments, it brings a crowd in, and it brings money into our branch. I think we have about 120 volunteers when you include the executive of the Legion, executive of the Ladies Auxiliary, fish and chip volunteers, dart players volunteering, pool players volunteering. The reason we're so successful is we have a lot of volunteers coming in, taking out the boxes, and we've been blessed the last 3 years or so with the old timers hockey players taking us under their wing and coming in and volunteering to go out on the poppy drive and set up in different stores and locations. And they have increased whereas we would, $100,000 was big. We're now, I think this past year, we've collected $180,000. Now, the Poppy Fund doesn't do anything really for our branch other than we're able to support our veterans and their families. None of the money can go to the operation of the Legion, which is too bad, because with $180,000, a small part of that would go a long way to paying a hydro bill or a gas bill or something in this place. Our expenses here on this Legion they run from $30,000 to $40,000 a month. So Poppy Fun is a big thing every year, and we need lots of volunteers, and the old timers hockey have stepped up and gave us that. So I think in order to maintain the Legion in Burlington, we need lots of volunteers. Well, I'm proud of the fact that I started out with three people on to be on the executive, getting that level up to 10. Now we have, I think we have an executive of 14, I believe it is now. Those people, I had to replace four executives in the 13 years. Three because they passed away, and one because the health failed and couldn't handle it anymore. But other than that, the original 9 or 10 that stood in the second year are still with me. And the new people that we've been able to come in, they've been serving six years, or once they get on, they stay. I'm proud of the fact that the Ladies Auxiliary is still together, which isn't that way in many legions. We get along great. They support us tremendously. And they're still the same executive as I started with. So I think some reason or other they feel like working hard. They work hard for me, and I'm really proud of that. My message is come in and join the Legion at the branch here so we can get to know you, talk to you, find out what your interests might be. If you want to volunteer, you don't have to volunteer, but it's nice to know whether we have people out there that want to join our Legion and want to volunteer to help our Legion. So that's my advice to anybody joining. Anybody renewing their membership, the same advice. Come in and see us. Renew it in the office. Our membership's there every Monday, 1 to 3. And you can talk to the committee members. Great camaraderie. Yeah, that's what we on the Poppy Drive, when we get the boxes of money in here, I was after them to get a cash counting counter. And the ladies almost threw me out, said, "This is camaraderie. We sit down, we enjoy ourselves, we talk, and have fun counting the money. Now you want to put it into a machine." So that's the type of thing that goes on. They don't see it as work, they see it as friendship and fun. We make do with what we got, and I think we do a tremendous job in the community. And we're being recognized now for that.
Thanks for the memory of sentimental verse. Nothing in my purse, and chuckles when the preacher said, for better or for worse,
how lovely it was.